concerns about the death of chess are well established, having been famously predicted by legends of the game from Jose Raul Capablanca to Bobby Fischer.
The truth is, chess is no good anymore.
But ever since the landmark match in 1997, when IBM supercomputer Deep Blue beat world champion superhuman Garry Kasparov, machines have been firmly in the ascendancy.
I'm always resisting Deep Blue being called intelligent machine. It was as intelligent as your alarm clock.
In the decades since, the mystery of chess has all but disappeared, thanks to the popularity of chess engines, able to predict, analyze, and advise far better than their human counterparts.
I'm sorry, Frank, I think you missed it.
Today, the game is booming.
Start your clock.
But the best players are artificial. So has the computer killed chess? The game is famously complex, with more possible iterations than atoms in the visible universe. The first five moves alone can be played out in 69,352,859,712,417 ways. Blimey. So how does a chess engine help? Unlike the $100 million Deep Blue, which used brute force programming to search its vast database for the best moves in any given situation, modern software like Stockfish and LC0 are able to perform more selective searches, faster, and for free.
But the strongest engines, the Alpha Zeros, are the ones who've had no human input. They've been told to basically just learn chess on their own, so they come up with these crazy opening ideas. And of course, the ones that have had no human input are better than the ones that have.
It doesn't have to be perfect. It just has to make less mistakes than the human opponent.
Running such an engine alongside a game against a mere super grandmaster, let alone a normal person, will see you win roughly 100% of the time.
You kind of sense when somebody is cheating. Like, there's a certain cleanness to their play. They just beat you very, very quickly.
I can't believe it. I'm losing to a rug.
You see this with any kind of online game such as poker. So it's not unique to chess. There's cheating everywhere. And the big problem with hosting online tournaments was that nobody trusted them. But the pandemic forced people to have to do it regardless. So a lot more people started relying on this anti-cheating algorithm, and the algorithm has gotten very good at detecting cheaters.
There is an irony in the use of algorithms to fix problems created by other algorithms, but computers have also accelerated the feeling that the variation and possibilities in the game are being exhausted.
Check me.
Bang.
And the thing when you play against computers, it's boring.
Checkmate.
It doesn't have a song.
Checkmate.
It does have a very clean quality that is almost destroying creativity. I think people become too obsessed with chess computers. You need to be able to switch off and use your own brain.
But the engines have also improved the game.
The engines have benefited us in many ways. I think the primary one is it's given us access. Growing up in Brooklyn, I had no access. But now you have a device in your pocket that you could say, analyze this. And it will tell you, you know what? Your move is just daft. They've got a teacher right at their disposal.
Computers have brought a new dimension into chess as well. They've opened up our understanding of how chess is played. And they're capable of pointing out moves that, you know, even very strong players aren't able to see.
They have radically disrupted the game. And it's not just in chess, AI is disrupting the world. But to me, disruption is a good thing. I like change. I think that you're seeing even more interesting chess, more dynamic chess, crazier chess erupt. And so it's incumbent on the professional players to deal with this change.
It's kind of paradoxical to think that this ancient game is being modernized right now, and that even chess, which doesn't change how it's played, has been made so different just by being put in the digital world.
He says he's not dead.
Yes, he is.
I'm not.
He isn't?
Well, he will be soon.
Perhaps what truly kills a game is when perfection is possible and the outcome predictable. This hasn't yet happened to chess, but simpler games like Noughts and Crosses, Connect Four and Guess Who have been solved. Even drafts will always end in a draw if played perfectly. But people still play these games.
I think it will get solved. Will that kill it? not completely, because I think people will still want to play the game. But yes, the mystery of chess will be removed. But maybe that's a load of rubbish anyway.
Maybe it will be exhausted. But there's so many variants that might become popular in some 22nd century iteration of chess.
Your illogical approach to chess does have its advantages on occasion, Captain.
Solving traditional chess is one thing, but the game is uniquely adaptable, with thousands of unsolved variants that will keep it one step ahead of the computers, for now.
Right now we're seeing rapid chess, blitz chess, in its ascendancy because people want things quicker. They want to see mistakes, they want to see drama, so that has taken over.
If you are putting it within these specific constraints of having a classical game with a specific time format, or you are randomizing where the pieces start, it's not about whether humans can do this better than computers or not. This is the pursuit of human excellence, same as you have with any other sport.